First up in our women's strawweight feature, coming out of the blue corner will be Lateesha, the Honey Badger Mohl.
Lateesha Mohl, the Honey Badger, 22 years old, fighting out of Lancaster, Pennsylvania.
The Honey Badger, that's a tough name to live up to.
She was very adamant about wanting me to call her the Honey Badger. There's a long lineage of honey badgers in MMA and football, and she wants to be the first woman honey badger. She's a striker. She's gonna stand and bang, she told me.
Well, you know what they say, honey badger don't give a... So we'll see.
We will see. This is our second bout of the night. Comes into women's strawweight division. Take a look at Lateesha Mohl. Jamie Butcher will be following her into the cage next. So I asked Jamie Mohl, Lateesha Mohl, excuse me, about, you know, being the more experienced fighter in there. She said, no, I'm not, because Jamie Butcher's 10-2 as a kickboxer. So she's not taking her opponent lightly at all.
Her opponent's coming out of the red corner, Jamie Butcher.
Here comes Jamie Butcher, like I said, and a very accomplished kickboxer, 10-2 in the amateur kickboxing circuit. Tonight she makes her MMA debut.
That experience, you know, even though it's separate sports, ring time and fight time is a big deal.
It is. It gets those jitters out of your system, so then you can just get in there and work. You don't have to worry about that nervousness or any of those, like, negative thoughts creeping in.
Of course. It's just like anything. Reps, reps, reps. You get in there. It's a kickboxing match, or it's MMA, or it's boxing. Just getting in there and doing it is half the battle, right, Eric?
Agreed. Most people can't even bring themselves to that.
Jamie's got Tom English and Tom Mohler there in the corner, two accomplished professional fighters in their own right. Tom was the Ring of Combat heavyweight champion and light heavyweight champion, if I'm not mistaken. He's also a jiu-jitsu black belt.
Let's take a look at the tail of tape for this strawweight feature bout. Jamie Butcher, 5 years older, like we talked about with that kickboxing pedigree. Jamie Butcher has a 4-inch height advantage, and you can see that the MMA experience tilts to the side of Lateesha Mohl. Both fighters weighing relatively the same weight. Let's throw it up to the center of the cage, Steve Peacock, to make this one official.
Triton Fights 9 is presented by Tiger Life Energy. Energy never tasted so good. And by Condemned Labs, LI Live Cryotherapy, Footlux of Long Island, Virtual Realms Beyond Average Apparel, and the Frameworks Design. Don't forget to join us tonight at the after party at Cans of Westfield. And now for our women's strawweight feature, Novice Rules Apply. First up, we have for you a 22-year-old fighter who stands at 5'2" and weighs 115 pounds. She has a 1-5 record, representing Ephrata Martial Arts out of Ephrata, Pennsylvania, out of the blue corner, Lateesha, the Honey Badger Mohl. Our next fighter is making her debut appearance and represents Comac MMA out of the red corner, Jamie Butcher.
Okay, we're ready for our second bout of the night. It's the women's strawweight feature. Jamie Butcher. Lateesha Mohl. The third man in the cage, referee Chris Wagner. We are underway. Lateesha Mohl in the all black, Jamie Butcher in the blue and black trunks. Right away, you see Lateesha come out trying to land those kicks. You can see she's going to want to stand and bang. Look at that form.
This is another similar body type matchup as with Ladisa and Rivera. You know, you got the shorter compactor and the longer and leaner.
And then southpaw unorthodox. Yeah.
Oh, nice kick. Getting a little taste of her own medicine. Lateesha Mohl on the receiving end of a beautiful kick from Jamie Butcher. Jamie Butcher, 22 years old, coming here from Lancaster, Pennsylvania. She said, don't let my 1-5 record fool you. I had a terrible gym. Started off with one of the worst gyms, bad coaching. She's 2-1 since she joined Ifreda Gym. You can see that right out of the gate. Good coaching there. Landed a nice overhand.
Very nice takedown.
A nice takedown, too. The Honey Badger.
I like that. Kneeling on the face.
That's some brutal stuff right there. Knee on neck, knee on face. That's...
It definitely gives you something to think about if you're on the bottom. It's something that you have to address before improving your position overall.
You got to figure Lateesha Mohl being the pedigree of kickboxing that she is, that maybe, you know, either Jamie Butcher's going to want to stay on the ground a little more, because the longer that they aren't, Jamie Butcher.
Oh, no, there's a triangle here.
As you say it, she goes for the triangle here, and that is locked in deep.
Almost. You know, with the shin guards, it's very difficult. There's another couple inches of padding on the front of the shin, but she is pretty long. I don't see any reason why she couldn't get it if she cuts a little bit more of an angle to her left.
She kind of disproves what my theory that I was trying to say. I was going to say Lateesha Mohl probably wants to stay on the ground, where Butcher probably isn't as comfortable being a kickboxer. That's not the case at all.
Well, I mean, as I said before, she's got a pretty world-class corner over there. Tom Mueller is a longtime jiu-jitsu black belt, and she's got Tom English, Ring of Combat veteran, Bellator veteran. She's got some good coaches over there in Comac MMA, so you know she's working on all aspects of her game, you know? And it's showing.
Is that an omoplata attempt? Woo!
She's using her body type really well. I like, you know, she's going for that long, those long.
Yeah, she goes for the arm bar. She's got the arm bar almost cinched up, it looks like, but she's got her arm in the crevice behind the knee of Mohl. Very difficult to get out.
Using the novice rules, there'll be no head striking while on the ground. Something to keep an eye on here. New York State rules, under three amateur fights, you got to use the novice rules.
Now, although Butcher is on her back, she has gone for two, possibly three submission attempts here.
Back up to their feet. Well, you see the kickboxing pedigree coming into play here. Both ladies trading at the end of round number one.
Very good first round.
I'll tell you what, Eric, our resident judge here. Another tough round to judge there. You saw good action from both fighters. You saw a nice, beautiful kick from Lateesha Mohl.
Mohl landed a very nice high kick early on, and then after they ended up on the ground, Butcher had several decent submission attempts. I mean, a very, very hard round to judge in MMA. What do you give credit for? Do you give credit for landing shots, or do you give credit for submission attempts that are coming close to ending the fight? That round was so even, I would call that round a draw. Dave, how do you feel about that?
Again, it's a very subjective type of round. You know, do you favor the big kick, the takedown, or what you're able to do with the takedown? Like, Jamie went for two very viable submission attempts, even a third. It really depends on what you give the credit to.
There's the beautiful kick.
It was a story of almost two separate halves of the round to me. The first portion I would give to Mohl, the second half I would give to Butcher for her action off the back.
I'd say I give it an even round draw.
I would agree.
See, we have it even in the last fight. It was a unanimous decision, so there wasn't any. The judges didn't see any of those three really close rounds in the first fight.
You can never know what the judges, you know. Like I said, everything is very subjective. What a nice Superman punch by Butcher.
Yeah, followed up with a two. Ooh, nice Mohl lands another two as well.
Very good jab.
Whoa. Oh, a little taunt there.
Butcher channeling her inner Diaz brother.
Stockton what?
Oh. Stockton slap.
You can tell Butcher's starting to find her range now. She's definitely getting loose, and she's letting those kickboxing chops hang out now, and it's
That's impressive.
I'd like to see Butcher as a southpaw land that body kick, that rear body kick to the liver, always super effective. And Mohl's keeping her back hand up high enough that it could slip in. Oh, there we go.
Ooh, very nice, nice left hand.
Beautiful left hand place. She knocks down Lateesha Mohl, going to the body on the ground. See, you know, you can just see it there, that Butcher doesn't really want anything on the ground. She wants to stay in the middle of the cage. She wants to stand and trade.
She's showing her fight IQ. You know, she's fighting to her strengths. And the way she's getting off with these strikes right now, I don't blame her.
Nice that, right hand.
That lead side kick that keeps sneaking under and landing, super effective. And it's super demoralizing to have something like that land on you over and over again in one round.
What I like is how she's landing that, and then the jab is coming immediately after behind it. There's no counter. She's shutting down the counter from Mohl with that.
Another little Superman punch. Ooh, push kick to the face that time.
Like we said, Jamie Butcher, she compiled a 10-2 record in the kickboxing world. Said she wanted to bring her talents to the MMA. Get more notoriety. You eventually make it to the top. There's more money involved.
You can see she's very calm as well. You know, that experience is playing a big factor here. She's remained calm. You know, she got hit with a big shot early in the first round, and it hasn't shook her at all. You know, she's been here.
Really impressive from Butcher, the fact that it's her MMA debut.
She's doing a good job with takedown defense against the cage as well. She has that one overhook, and she keeps fishing her right hand inside. Now she's able to push off and get back to her feet.
Tell you what, though, Mohl is game. She keeps coming forward.
The honey badger.
It has not slowed her down one bit.
Really she's tough.
Yeah. Let's see if she can figure out the puzzle.
Her game plan coming in, she says, I know my opponent's much taller than me, but I'm not going to let her get inside. Hasn't really been the case this round, as Butcher's been getting some good work in.
Oh, nice right hand. Left hand, excuse me.
Right down the pipe.
Ooh, a little double kick action right there.
And all the activity from Butcher is really kind of stunted Mohl here. She hasn't really been able to get off this round, mostly because Butcher's just been on the offensive the entire time.
Now that's what Mohl needs to do, but just 2 minutes earlier.
That was an easier round to judge, I believe. I'm going to go out on a limb and say that you had Butcher winning that one 10-9.
Yeah, it was a 10-9 round for Butcher. Now, Mohl is able to get the takedown. It seems like it's just something she's going to have to focus on getting much, much earlier.
You know, she's having a hard time solving the riddle standing up. You know, she's at a reach disadvantage, and you can see that the striking skill set is a little bit more towards Jamie Butcher, so she's having a hard time bridging that gap. We'll see if she can make the adjustments here in this round.
Take a look at some of the action from round number two, brought to you by Tiger Life. So according to Eric Ott's card right now, Butcher is up 19-18. Mostly from what you're seeing right here. Round number two tilted the way of Jamie Butcher. Of course, these are unofficial scorecards. If you have any issues, it's ericott@gmail.com.
That's going to go to other Eric Ott, but you can complain to them all you want.
Mail?
You can complain to other Eric Ott all you want. Singer-songwriter Eric Ott,
I didn't know there was more than one of you.
My arch nemesis.
Round number three, you're underway here. It's a straw weight women's matchup, very competitive.
Now Mohl keeps circling to her right, which is into the power of Butcher, which is definitely not the best thing to do to a taller, longer opponent.
She's able to close the distance here. This is where she wants it.
See, I feel like she did really well setting up her takedowns from the outside with strikes and then coming in and grabbing the leg. She's had no luck with upper body takedowns thus far.
As for Mohl, haven't seen a lot of activity from her since round number one. Round number two was a really good round for Butcher. So, well, that's you, Dave. If you're Lateesha Mohl, what do you got to do here just to score some points?
You know, she's got to figure out a way to get on the inside and get that takedown. You know, she's not scoring enough on the feet, and she's being backed up by the longer fighter. So if I'm Mohl, I got to look to try and get inside and get this takedown.
There she is. That's a chance. She's got to get down lower on the thighs with Butcher if she's going to effectively take her down. She's got to get those hands clasped behind, and she's got to suck her legs out and pull her legs towards the center of the octagon so she ends up on her butt.
How come Mohl isn't throwing any more leg kicks? What do you think, sir? Nice takedown. But no, bad positioning.
She's got that underhook, but she's unable to use it, and Butcher gets full mount now.
Let's see what Butcher does here.
A lot of time to work here, a minute and a half left.
Keep in mind, you cannot strike to the head while on the ground, body shots only.
This is a very difficult or strange position to be in, because theoretically in fighting, this is one of the most dominant positions that you can possibly be in. But as an amateur, in your first couple fights, you're made to wear shin guards in New York State just as a safety precaution, and you're not allowed to punch to the head while on the ground.
Right.
So it sort of renders you in a grappling match position, except a grappling match where you're wearing thick foam shin guards and gloves, which makes submissions much, much more difficult to successfully enact.
Yeah, if I was Butcher here, I would kind of let her up and get to the middle of the cage and just keep, you know, throwing kicks, throwing punches, which she does best.
Yeah, but this is a win position for her right now. She just has to sit here and ride it out, and she's got 2 and 3 in the bag.
Tell you what, though, I'm impressed. You know, Butcher showed a well-rounded skill set here. She's not just a kickboxer. You know, she's got some grappling acumen here.
Now, my first amateur fight with shin guards in New Jersey ended very similarly to this, except I kneeled on one of my opponent's arms and was able to lock the triangle up from the top. I thought we might see that earlier because you had her knee on the shoulder of Mohl.
It did look like she was trying to set that up.
Final 10 seconds here in the fight. Jamie Butcher putting the finishing touches on what we believe will be the first win of her young career.
That's an exciting fight. A lot of action.
Really good fight. Really good. Back and forth. Good really skill good. From both sides.
That was nice a good striking. Showcase of MMA. You know, there was a little takedown, some good striking. And,
Eric, how'd you have round 3 and ultimately the fight?
I'd say that was definitely a 10-9 round for Butcher. And I have the score 29-27 for Butcher.
I agree with you there. Take a look at some of the work here done in this fight, brought to you by Footlux of Long Island. Butcher was able to get some takedowns.
Mohl was game. You know, she never stopped coming forward. You know, she was on the receiving end of some punishment there on the feet, but she never stopped trying to enact a game plan, and she was coming to still try to finish, you know.
Will it be Lateesha Mohl, or will it be Jamie Butcher, who doesn't have a mark on her face? She's ready to go out tonight to the after party at Cannes. Judges are tabulating their scorecards here. Everything leading up to our main event of the night, the ISKA lightweight title between Paul Timothy and Dylan Mantello. It's coming up later tonight. But right now, we'll find out the winner of this women's strawweight feature, Lee Peacock. He has the results.
And now we go to the judges' scorecards. Judge A scored 29-28. Judge B scored 29-28. Judge C scored 29-28. For the winner, by unanimous decision, came out of the red corner, Jamie Butcher!
Jamie Butcher gets the first win of her young career after a dominant kickboxing career. Let's hear what she has to say. She'll catch up with Dave Della Rocca right now.
I'm here with Jamie Butcher. She just collected her very first MMA victory. You brought in a lot of kickboxing experience and a lot of, you know, in-cage fight time. You looked real calm out there. You had a little early adversity with that kick in the first round, but, you know, I was impressed. Well-rounded and against a real tough opponent. How are you feeling?
I feel great. I feel awesome.
I saw you bouncing around even after the fight. You know, you look fresh, like you could do another 3 right now.
I'm waking up. Let's go.
So is your focus now on MMA? You're sticking to MMA, or you're going to be a two-sport athlete?
I'm focused on everything. I want to be well-rounded. I want to do kickboxing, MMA, everything. I want to start doing grappling tournaments, you know. I mean.
Well, you looked really well-rounded. You didn't look like only a kickboxer. You showed off a pretty good, sharp grappling acumen as well. Very impressive. Congratulations.
Great performance from Jamie Butcher. Hope to see her again in the Triton Fights cage. She moves to 1-0 in her young career.